In this video, we'll cover the topic of present continuous tense. Let's look at the learning objective of today's session. By the end of today's session, the students will be able to understand the basic structure and the usage of present continuous tense. They will also be able to understand the difference between the usage of present indefinite and present continuous tense. Let's discuss the usage of present continuous tense first. The very basic usage of present continuous tense is that we use present continuous tense to refer to things that are happening at the moment we are talking about them. For instance, if I say I am teaching tenses. Now I'm talking about it, but at the same time, the teaching is in progress. So it's happening at the very moment. And these things usually last for quite a short time, and they're not finished by at the moment we are talking about them. So let's look at some of the examples of this usage. I'm working at the moment. So this is something that is my current state. The action is being taken place right now at this very moment. Another example, please call back as we are eating dinner right now. So again, this is something that we are doing at the moment. Third example could be, the baby is sleeping. Now again, the baby is sleeping at the moment. So this is something that is happening at the current moment. We can also use this tense for referring to some kind of temporary situation. Even if the action is not happening at this very moment. For instance, John is working in a restaurant until he finds a job in his field. Now with this, I don't mean that, you know, John is working at this very moment. He's not, he might not be working at this time of the day. What I mean is that John is working in a restaurant these days. So I'm referring to sort of a temporary state of John, though the action might not be happening at the present moment. Okay. Another example could be, I'm reading a great book. Now with this, I do not mean that at this very moment, at this time of the day, I'm reading a great book. What I mean to say is that these days, it's my temporary state. These days I'm reading a great book. Third example could be, she's staying with her friend for a week. Now this is her temporary state. So for a week, maybe, until her family finds a home, she's living with her friend. So this is her temporary state. So this is kind of another example or usage of present continuous tense. It's a small comparison between present indefinite tense and present continuous tense, because we are already done with present indefinite. So we must know what is the basic difference between the two aspects of the same tense. So when I say I work in a school, now this is sort of a permanent situation. I normally work in a school. I work in a school. This is my permanent state. But if I say I'm working in a school, this sort of reflects a temporary state of mind. I'm working in a school. It might mean that I'm working these days in a school. I might not be working in a school. Maybe if I have something else. So this is sort of more of at a temporary side as compared to the previous example. So this is sort of one of the basic difference between present indefinite tense and present continuous tense. Now let's discuss the structure of present continuous tense. So we all know the structure of present indefinite tense that we discussed in the last video: subject, verb and object. Here, because we are referring to the current action going on, the basic difference is adding a helping verb or an auxiliary verb before the first form of verb. And also, the first form of a verb is used in present continuous tense as well, but it is used with ing, and then it is followed by an object. Now let's look at some of the example of affirmative sentence. We all know that affirmative sentences are positive sentences. So they are playing. Now, why have I used the helping verb are instead of is or am? Because they, with they and we and you, we use the helping verb are. If the subject is singular, like he, she, it, then we use the helping verb is. So she is baking cake, or he is playing guitar. All these actions are happening at this very moment. I can see them playing. They're playing. She's baking cake. I can smell it. I can see her baking a cake. Or he is playing a guitar, which means I can hear him playing the guitar. So all these actions are happening at the moment. Now comes the negative sentences. He's not working. The entire sentence structure remains the same with helping verb, subject followed by helping verb, but before the main verb, not is used because it's a negative state. This is something that is not happening right now. They are not coming. I'm not cooking food. And with I, we always use the helping verb, I am. Let's look at some of the examples of interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences means question sentences. So are they going for a picnic tomorrow? Now, because it's a question, so the helping verb will precede the subject. And since the subject is plural, so are will be used. So are they going for a picnic tomorrow? Is she working late at night? Because she is singular. Or are you exercising? So with you, we always use are. So are, since it's a question, are will come before you. Okay, so now that we have discussed the structure of present continuous tense, let us discuss some of the interesting uses of present continuous tense, which are different from the traditional uses of present continuous tense that we come across. So one of the very interesting usage of present continuous tense is basically to use it to refer to events or actions that are comparatively new and that are new as compared to the events that have happened in the past. And in this case, the tense basically sort of help us provide a contrast between the present situation and the old situation. For instance, these days, people are writing emails a lot less than they used to a few years ago. Now, here our aim is not simply to refer to an action that is happening at this very moment. For example, saying I'm writing email, which is I'm just telling that what I'm doing right now. But here we are actually making a sort of comparison that these days people are writing email less as compared to what they used to do a couple of years ago from now. Another interesting usage could be using present continuous tense for referring to a regular habit that someone has, whether it's a good habit or it's a bad one. For example, you're always running late with all your deadlines. Now, if you remember, in the present indefinite tense, one of the very basic usage of present indefinite tense that we had discussed was using it to refer to general habits. For example, you are always late. So, you know, you're referring to somebody's habitual action. But again, you can use present continuous or tense also in this context, though this might not be common, but this is one way of using it for just saying you're always running late with all your deadlines. Another very interesting usage of present continuous tense is that it can also be used when you're talking about some of the current trends. Now, for example, online shopping is growing in popularity nowadays. So here my aim is to refer to something that has become a trend these days. Another example could be the stocks are dropping constantly due to the economy. So again, because this is something that has been happening for a long time now, the economy and the stocks are dropping. So this is something that has become a trend. Yet another example could be today most people are using text messages instead of phone. So again, a sort of some comparison between what used to happen before and something that has become a trend just recently. So using text messages has become a trend. So this is yet another usage of present continuous tense. So in this video, we have specifically focused on discussing the usage of present continuous tense, in which context it is used. Then I have referred to one of the basic difference that exists between present indefinite tense and present continuous tense, so that we know that in which context we should use which tense and which is more appropriate in a particular situation. Then I have discussed the structure of present continuous tense, the structure for affirmative sentences, the use of subject, the helping verb, subject-verb agreement, then verb with ing form followed by an object, the structure for negative sentences, the structure for forming an interrogative sentence. And in the end, I have also discussed some of the interesting uses of present continuous tense. So I hope that by the end of this session, you have understood the different usages of present continuous tense and its structure. Thank you.